All those doing them shall have a good understanding. His praise is standing forever. I want to read that just one more time. I want to read it again. And that's Psalms 111, verse 10. The fear of Yahweh is the beginning of wisdom. All those doing them have a good understanding. His praise is standing forever.
Hallelujah.
So, fear. Fear is the beginning of wisdom. Let's turn to Exodus. Chapter 4. And we will begin there. And I'll start at verse 1. And Moshe answered and said, and if they do not believe me, nor listen to my voice, and say, Yahweh has not appeared to you, and Yahweh said to him, what is that in your hand? And he said, a rod. And he said, throw it on the ground. So he threw it on the ground, and it became a serpent. And Moshe fled from it. And Yahweh said to Moshe, reach out your hand and seize it by the tail. So he reached out his hand and took hold of it. And it became a rod in his hand. So that they believe him, so that they believe that Yahweh, Elohim, Elohim of their fathers, the Elohim of Abraham, the Elohim of Yishak, and the Elohim of Yaakov have appeared to you.
Yes.
And Yahweh said to him again, now, put your hand in your bosom. And he put his hand in his bosom. And when he took it out, and see, his hand was leprous like snow. And he said, put your hand in your bosom again. So he put his hand in his bosom again and drew it out of his bosom. And see, it was restored like the other flesh. And it shall be, if they do not believe you, nor listen to the voice of the first sign, they shall believe the voice of the latter sign.
Well.
And it shall be, if they do not believe either, even these two signs, or listen to your voice, that you shall take water from the river and pour it on dry land. And the water which you shall take from the river shall become blood on dry land. So here's where we're going to begin to take a look. And I'm really going to miss my images today and my scriptures that I normally would have prepared. But if you follow along, we'll do okay. So there's three signs here that is spoken with Moshe. The first one is that when he puts his hand in his bosom, first he has a concern. Let's go with that first. The concern is, what if they don't believe me? Now, this is when Yahweh is setting Moshe up to go into Israel, gather the elders, and to speak to them of deliverance. And so his concern before he even got there was, what if they don't believe me, nor listen to my voice? And so if they don't believe me, nor listen to my voice, and Yahweh spoke from there, verse 3, and he said, let me go back one. And Yahweh said to him, what is that in your hand? And he said, a rod. So the first one, or the first sign, let's look at the three signs. A rod, his hand, and dry land turning to blood. So the rod, his hand, put it in his bosom, take it out, and then take water from dry land and from the river and pour it on dry land. And it became blood. So let me do this first. I want to summarize each of those three. This is not an unfamiliar message. This is something that we're all familiar with. We've gone over it. You've heard it before. You've read it before. So I'm just going to kind of skip around this just a little. So the summary that I have for these three is one word: fear. For the three signs, the rod, his hand changing, and water that turns to blood. Each of those, as I've been doing my research and trying to come up with what is the commonality here, what should we know as a people from these three signs? And I do believe that the signs are working in increments of time. He said, if these two don't work, then take some water from the river, pour it out on dry land, and it shall become blood. Now, what I want to impress on you is the timeline of this is before he's gone into Egypt, Mitzrayim. He has not gone there yet. And so Yahweh is speaking to him and telling him what to do. And these three signs will play a major part, of which Yahweh said, so that they will believe you forever. Now that's powerful. Only Yahweh can do something like that, because it's been recorded that they didn't believe him. Remember, they didn't leave out because of hardness of heart. The scripture says, because due to hardness of spirit, they had a hard time believing Moshe.
Right.
That along with Pharaoh, you know, in his part. But I want to stay focused on these three pieces, which is the rod. Let's start with the rod. Let's identify. Yahweh asked, what is that in your hand? A rod. Throw it down. What did it become? The serpent. What was Moshe's reaction when he saw it become a serpent? He ran.
Yes, it did.
Scripture says he fled. And so as he fled, fear factor kicked in. Get away from it. Now, he brought it with him. He brought it there. But because of fear, he fled the rod, which became what? A serpent. Now comes the instructions. Moshe, pick it up by the tail. So Yahweh gave him an instruction to pick up the rod by the tail, which is now a serpent. And because of his fear, he fled. But because Yahweh gave him instructions, he picked it up. Now, here's the first problem. If you're going to pick up a snake, and I don't advise to do that, you wouldn't want to pick it up by the tail because you're still within strike zone. The defense of a snake is its reach. It coils and then strike within its reach. And so to pick it up by the tail, a snake handler would never do something like that. A snake handler would somehow catch it by the neck, and he has control because he really has no other defense other than to strike, bite, venom that is poisonous. Other than that, then you have the different types of snakes, of course, we understand. But staying focused, the strike is in the bite. And so here's the fear. So let me introduce another word. We have fear. I want you to keep fear in the top of your mind. And another word I want to use is different. Different. Everybody repeat this after me. Fear.
Fear.
Different.
Different.
Now, looking at these two items, what was fearful right here was the rod that became a snake, right? And because the rod became a snake, fear came over Moshe. And as fear came over Moshe, he ran to preserve what? His life. And so, the word different, I want to expound on just a little bit more, but I want to bring in another word. Stages. Stages. So we have fear, different, and stages. Can you repeat those three? Fear.
Fear.
Different.
Different.
Stages.
Stages.
Rabbi too has been working on a series, Stages of Life. And so in the stages of life, he's giving us examples of how on the stake, Yeshua has become our salvation. But there's different stages that we go through. And we begin to learn the stages of what Yahweh has done to preserve our lives. And so I want to tag on to what he's doing there by just going in the opposite direction, but stages of death. Stages of death, we may not recognize right away, but there is a purpose that stages of death is supposed to bring us to, which Moshe recognized right away. And so that brings me to the next thing I want to bring in. We have the rod that changed to a serpent. The next sign was Moshe, put your hand in your bosom. Pull it out. It changed. It became leprous. And as it became leprous, the scripture says, like snow. Verse 6. And Yahweh said to him again, now put your hand in your bosom. And he put his hand in his bosom. And when he took it out, and see, his hand was leprous like snow. Leprous. And this is for Lori. She kind of pointed me at something as we were talking about this in Midrash. And so I had to do some research and come up with what, just really, what are they talking about? What is Yahweh talking about here? What is he talking about? Leprous. Leprous is a verb here. It's the state of being. His hand became what? Leprous. And then there's an adjective like snow, which is really a simile when you use the word like. So it was like snow, but it's a description of what it looked like. So today, when we try to figure out, well, what is leprosy? What does it look like? What is leprous? We really don't have a good idea of what it looks like because, you know, it's something that we read about in Leviticus chapter 13 and 14. It's very big, huge chapters. And it talks about if the flesh of a man's body become swollen, scales, if it becomes white or black hairs come out of it. It gives full descriptions about leprosy. And so that's a huge study. So again, I'm only going to tap into it. Because it's huge by itself. Let's go there for a moment, because I don't want to not give a good look or a good image of this picture. Let's go to verse 1, chapter 13, verse 1. We're on the second side. And Yahweh spoke to Moshe and to Aharon. When a man has on the skin of his body a swollen, a scab, or a bright spot, and it has become on the skin of his body like a leprous infection, then he shall be brought to Aharon the priest, or to one of his sons, the priest. Everyone say the priest. What has happened today is what was given to the priest is now given to the medical community. Verse 3, and the priest shall look at the infection on the skin of the body, and if the hair on the infection has turned white, and the infection appears to be deeper than the skin of his body, it is a leprous infection, and the priest shall look at him and pronounce him unclean. Unclean. Now, you've seen these images in the movies, videos, where they were trying to portray the time of the Exodus and people during the time of Yeshua even, where they would have to say, cover their upper lip, and announce to all around them, unclean, unclean. And the person themselves would have to be, in this case, not set apart, but set aside. And so as they're set aside from the community, because it can be contagious, then they are set aside from mainstream society because you don't want to get other people sick. And so therefore it is your duty now to pronounce yourself as unclean. Now, here's one thing I want to bring out according to leprosy. Now remember, his hand changed, right? But his hand was also restored. He put his hand back in his bosom and he pulled it out again. And his hand was like the rest of his flesh, restored, right? And so we have fear, we have different. So in this scenario, what I want to bring out, I don't know what color he was before he changed. But what I do know is what the scripture tells me is that it was like snow. I'll read it again. Let me go back there. Verse 6, Exodus chapter 4, verse 6. And Yahweh said to him again, now put your hand in your bosom. And he put his hand in his bosom. And when he took it out, and see, his hand was leprous like snow. So our verb is a state of being. His hand was in a state of being. It was different. Different from the rest of his flesh. He put his hand back in his bosom, took it back out, and it was restored to what was the rest of his flesh. But whatever took place, it looked like snow. And here's where Lori kind of pushed me into really digging into this. Because right away, my thought is, if it turned white, what color was it before it turned white? Now, if it turned white, and we've already read in Leviticus chapter 13, where there is an imagery of white according to leprosy. While I could really stay right here and just kind of dig into, you know, my own thoughts of what this could really be, I have to thank my daughter Lori because she kind of, again, kind of made me kind of look at this and she said, no, what about disease? So by looking up some information on it, she right away recognized that leprosy also means disease. So, as I studied it since that time, really beginning to try to dig in and understand, why would Yahweh bring us into two parts of this? He give us the disease part, and then he tell us like snow is what it looks like. But right away, to me, my mind is made up. Hey, he turned different from what it was. And so what he turned, his hand turned white. And so when it was restored to whatever color it was in the beginning. And so what we have right away is something that is feared. Because what did Moshe again see? Fear. Because whatever he saw, whether it was disease or was a distortion of color, it was fear. And so what I have to summarize is that he saw something that gave change. Because now here's the other door that was opened up for me as I began to study this out. You can't always see disease. Disease can be visible or invisible. Visible or invisible. If it's inward, if it's disease of the blood, if it's disease inside, no one can see that. You may not even know that until you go to the doctor. You may have a feeling of not wellness. You may get some kind of sign that tells you something is not right. And so if something is not right, you're trying to figure out, what do I need to do to make it right? So in the first two signs, my summary is fear once again. And so when Yahweh told him, what is that in your hand? He threw down the rod. It became a serpent. He ran because of fear. Second sign, let me give you what the first sign is. The first sign is Mount Sinai. The totality of Mount Sinai. If you, then I. It's the seesaw effect. Here's a quick example of the seesaw. Let's take two children. One child is about 100 pounds and the other child is 25 pounds. Put them both on the seesaw. You put the child that's 25 pounds on the seesaw and then the child that's 100 pounds, and right away what's going to happen? He's going to give way to the heavier weight. But over time, that child is going to realize and figure it out that if I can equal the weight, if I can balance, if I can bring balance, we can have some fun. And so this is basically what we're looking at, trying to figure out where is the balance. What's the balance? What do I need to do? I'm not feeling good. I'm not feeling well. But you may not be able to tell. You might have to ask me, are you okay? You may not see what's going on inside of me, but I can express to you, I'm not feeling good. Or is it that Moshe saw a change? I believe that Moshe saw a physical change in our scenario for today. And fear came over him. Why? Because his hand changed. And so his hand was a sign. And so fear, different. Let's see. So if something is different, do we fear it? So we can fear what is different. So what is different? And I'm just really pulling out some things that give us the totality or the total sum of different. His hand was different, brought in fear. And because his hand was different, fear came over him. He had a rod in his hand, but the rod became what? A serpent. So it's no longer what it was. It became something what? Different. And because it became something different, he was fearful and he ran. But Yahweh gave him instructions, and the rod really represents authority because he gave him the authority and the instructions over the rod. And the rod became once again what? A rod. And so, verse 7. And he said, put your hand in your bosom again. And so he put his hand in his bosom again, and he drew it out of his bosom. And see, it was restored like the other flesh. And it shall be, if they do not believe you, nor listen to the voice of the first sign. Again, the first sign is what? Mount Sinai. Everything is a summary. It's not just, you know, one thing or the other, but it's a summary of everything at Mount Sinai. If you don't keep the commandments, what is the consequence? Death. Fear. We have a fear of what? Dying. So if we have a fear of dying, is that our serpent? Let's take an infant, newborn. It's happening now. Newborn has no intellect of fear. They're taught to fear. By who? The parents. But when they're first born, let's say day one, day two, day three, week one, week two, week three, they have no fear. But it's a growing process that as they have need, they learn fear. The first thing they want is to be fed. And if they're not fed, what do? They cry. And so that brings the attention to mom and dad that I want to be fed. And so they begin to learn right away, if I cry, they'll feed me. And so if I cry, they'll feed me. But they've not yet learned to fear death. They have no consciousness of death. They're just born. That only increases with time. And so as they grow, mom and dad is beginning to teach them, don't do this, don't do that. Why? Death. You may not explain to them death or what death is, but over time, they begin to learn more and more about what? Death, separation of life. So we got the stages of death in an infant. Yahweh created us, mankind. Mankind didn't understand death. They just existed. But Yahweh had to teach man death and why it was not a good thing. Because if you die before your time and sin has separated you, there's something eternal going on. And so he must teach us about what? Death. And so in the stages of death, he's trying to keep us what? Alive. And so if he wants us to live, then he must teach us to fear. Now, what did we say fear was? The beginning of wisdom, right? And so what it really says is the fear of Yahweh is the beginning of wisdom. And so if the fear of Yahweh is the beginning of wisdom, and right away he introduces us to this rod that becomes a snake, that's fear. And so this is so that they will believe you forever. And then his hand in his bosom brings in what? Disease. Whether we understand what leprosy looks like or is, it's something that's not good that if unattended can lead to what? Death. And so forever we have diseases that can take our lives. Now, an infant wouldn't understand this, but as a parent, you do. And so you teach your children all the differences and the stages of death without always just saying, this will cause death. Don't touch that, you'll die. Don't do that, you'll poke your eye out, then you'll die. Don't, you know what I'm saying? All these different things that as a child, you begin to learn not to do. Why? Because death. So let's go back and review, and I'm almost done, really. Let's go back and review the three pieces. The three pieces, we have the rod. We have his hand. And we have the water that turned to blood. And so, in Leviticus chapter 13 and 14, like I said, huge. How, once a man has been pronounced unclean, do he become clean? He is introduced to what it takes. Let's bring in one other thing. Not only is it according to our skin, but it's a house, our garments, it's leather, just different things. And each thing, according to the nature of it, has stages of life and death. So you show yourself to the priest, and he locks you up for 7 days, not as in going to take you to jail, but you are quarantined basically for how long? 7 days. And so for 7 days you are not among the mainstream, because now what he must do is follow the signs of leprosy. And as he is following the signs of leprosy, he's keeping up whether or not you are contagious, unclean, or you're healed. At the end, in the seventh day, if you are healed, then he pronounces you are healed. And then you can be resubmitted or you can rejoin the mainstream. And so, with that said, looking at fear, once again, being the total sum of the rod, the hand, the water, Yahweh says, these are so that they will learn to fear Yahweh. And to learn to fear Yahweh, you learn to live. And so Yahweh gives us the Sabbath, the holy days, and everything to keep us alive. And so I'm going beyond the hand in his bosom now, beyond the blood poured out on dry land. And so the total sum being fear, but the fear of what's different. And so what's different is anything that's different from me. If my hand is different, then I'm fearful what's the problem. If you're different from me, some people are just fearful of what's different. And so Why would Yahweh give us these three signs and say that they will learn to fear Yahweh and remain alive? Verse 8. And it shall be, if they do not believe you, nor listen to the voice of the first sign, they shall believe the voice of the latter sign. And it shall be, verse 9, if they do not believe even these two signs, or listen to your voice, that you shall take water from the river and pour it on dry land, and the water which you have taken from the river shall become blood on the dry land. And Moshe said to Yahweh, O Yahweh, I am not a man of words, neither before nor since you have spoken to your servant, for I am slow of speech and slow of tongue. And Yahweh said to him, Who has made man's mouth? Or who makes dumb, or deaf, or seeing, or blind? Is it not I, Yahweh? So right here, what we see is difference again. Dumb, deaf, blind. And so that's someone who may be different from me, or am I different from everyone else? I'm blind, can't see. So all of these things cause us to do what? Search. Fear causes us to search. What do you want to know? What is the root cause? Why am I different? Sin separates us. And so, with sin being the difference, now we're getting to the root cause. The rod was what for what? Authority over sin, right? The hand, disease, invisible or visible. All types of things. We're trying to focus in on exactly what was it, you know, how did his hand look? But what I want to submit, is it disease, invisible, and visible? Is it fear of what's different? And what's different right now for Moshe is his hand. But now let's spread that out over the nations, over the whole earth, over mankind. We're all different. Something's wrong with you. Something's right with me. Something's not right with me. Something wrong with you. Things happen, and diseases are the cause, or sin is the causes of disease. And so as we become diseased, Yahweh gives us an out with the Sabbath, the holy days, kashrut, correct eating. So all of these different things are a way to be. And so, last point, and I'm going to close from here. The book of Revelation, let's go there, chapter 8. And I'm going to finish up from there as we're trying to Revelation chapter 8, verse 8. And the second messenger sounded, and what looked like a great mountain burning with fire was thrown into the sea. And a third of the sea became blood, and a third of the living creatures in the sea died. And a third of the ships were destroyed. And a third messenger sounded, and a great star fell from the heavens, burning like a torch. And it fell on a third of the rivers and on the fountains of water. And it came, and the name of the star is called Wormwood. And a third of the waters became wormwood. And many men died from the waters because they were made bitter. And a fourth messenger sounded, and a third of the sun was struck, and a third of the moon, and a third of the stars, so that a third of them were darkened, and a third of the day did not shine, and likewise the night. And I heard verse 13, and I looked, and I heard an eagle flying in the mid-heaven, crying with a loud voice, "Woe, woe, woe to those dwelling upon the earth, because the remaining blast of the trumpets of the third messenger who are about to sound, and actually I'm going to stop there with the fourth trumpet. And so, in summary, the reason I bring in now seven trumpets is because when the priest looks at the leprous man, he shuts him up how many days? 7 days. And at the end of 7 days, if he's not healed, he shut him up again for another 7 days. And so he is then pronounced clean once the leprosy or the stages are seeming to go away. And so that, once again, you got to go back to Leviticus chapter 11 on that. But just for our illustration, that there is stages of death just as there are stages of life. And so if you don't take care of a disease, you're going to eventually die. Take gangrene. I don't know what they do for it now, but I know years ago, if you got gangrene in your hand, what do? They cut it off. So it don't spread to the rest of the body, because you will die from the disease. And so if you die from the disease, it's over. So there's process of time, which is, I like to call Yahweh's grace. Gangrene is grace, because you have time. That's what grace is. You have time, cut it off and live. And so if you cut your hand off, then the rest of the body shall live. But if you ignore it, there's clearly something different about your hand. Now, I want you to relate this to Moshe. He gives us one thing, but we need to see multiple things, right? So he shows us Hasatan, but we need to also see that there's demons, there's evil, there's a whole lot of things that comes behind Hasatan. But you have power and authority over him if you follow the instructions, which is the Torah, which is the law, which is what was given in the first sign. So if they don't believe you with the first sign, Mount Sinai, if they don't believe you with the first sign, then put your hand in your bosom. The second sign, disease is all over the world. We are suffering. We are dying. This is the most drugged up nation. This is the most drugged up generation in the world. All kind of medicine. We go to the doctor for everything. And the first thing they're going to do is put you on medication. If you're not sick, take medication so you can get sick, so we can give you something to cure that. But the medical industry is one of the largest, most economically sound base economics of today. It's behind everything. And so, Moshe's hand represents disease. And unless you learn to fear, you will die. And so, our stages of death is trying to get you to live. Yahweh is trying to get you to live. So the beginning, the fear of Yahweh is the beginning of what? Wisdom, because he wants us to live. He never put these things on us to die. He put them on us to live. So as an infant, they don't know about life and death. They just know they're living. They just know they exist. But as they grow, they begin to learn more about what death is, because the parents teach them. Yahweh is teaching us. So the first sign, the rod of authority, became a snake. He feared and ran. The second sign, his hand became leprous. It changed. I think there was something visible that made him fear what his hand had become. And what did his hand become? Different from the rest of his body. So we fear things that are different. And so that makes us search out why. Or why is my hand different? Or why do I feel different? Why am I not feeling good? Because there's something going on. And so it begins our search for the question, why? And so, if they don't understand either of those, then take some water from the river and pour it out on dry ground, and it will become blood. And so today, what we have is nations all around the world. Are seeing rivers that are changing, becoming red as blood. And so, as the religious community begin to recognize this, our governments are explaining it away, saying we have crimson tides, or we have chemical plant spills, or they're giving all types of explanations as to why the river has turned red. I really wish I had my images now. But you can imagine what I'm talking about. And really what I'm talking about now are the seven trumpets that are being poured out on the earth, or mankind. Is this to kill us? Or is it to warn us? Is it for us to become fearful? And some people are trying to deny the fear by explaining logically why this happened, instead of recognizing Yahweh is getting ready to come to sit on his throne and to take over every government and to govern his people, so that we will live and not die. Right. And so the fear factor for some people are being dismissed. But for those who have eyes to see, ears to hear, can understand and begin to understand that the seven trumpets are being poured out around the nations. And as they're beginning to be poured out, we're beginning to see with our own eyes what Yahweh said to Moshe, so that they will believe you forever and listen to the voice. So what if they don't believe me nor hear my voice? And so Yahweh gave him only three signs. And I can take those three signs and give you examples of everything that we're going through, both good and bad. But it's up to you whether you should believe. It's up to you. You choose what you believe. But I guarantee you this, that if the second sign don't get you, the third one will. Because when Yahweh is finished pouring out blood on the earth, people will begin to really try to figure out, why are so many people dying? Why did my mother die, my parents died, my children died, or different ones who died? Why am I dying? People will at some point begin to realize we need to live and not die. So the seven trumpets are representation of our priest who's getting ready to come back and sprinkle us seven times and then pronounce us clean. So the blood is being applied, and the blood has been applied. And so the blood is still powerful, and the word that went out to Moshe is still relevant. Can we give Yahweh a praise?
Everyone needs compassion, love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone.